On New Year's Day, me and my friend Norbu Tundup left for Shade to celebrate their Loser festival. And what followed next was a fascinating first encounter with one of the most unique and isolated communities of Ladakh. We reached Pukhtar only on the previous afternoon on December 31st. I was a bit disappointed at not being able to spend more time at the monastery, but at least I was able to meet the monks and give them a solar water heater as a gift for all their hospitality last winter. It was very difficult to bring the equipment safely from Padam. The road was very bumpy at places, and with every bump we felt as if the glass pipes would break and render the heater useless. But thankfully, we managed to get to the end of the road without damaging the pipes, and the lamas took over from there, carrying the item safely to the monastery on the chadar. Shade is reachable by a narrow trail 23 kilometers from Pukhtar, and while the locals can easily do it in a day, I with my heavy backpack would need 2 days to reach Shade, just in time for the New Year celebrations to start on the eve of Loser. It was January 1st, but there was no snow at all anywhere on the trail, just a clear path to follow all the way along the Sarabchu River. After a while, we reached a place called Sumdo, where the trail leaves the Sarabchu River and goes inside a side valley towards Shade. A couple of hours later, I felt very tired and felt as if I was holding back my companions. So I asked them to carry on and camped by a nice spot beside the stream. The next morning, I woke up to a changed landscape. It had snowed early in the morning, and there was a light dusting of snow everywhere. It felt more like winter now, and I very much enjoyed hiking in this snow-covered landscape. Soon, I reached the small hamlet of Taltak and met the people of Shade there. They had come from the village to chain the juniper branches and the lato leading up to their village. They do this every year on the eve of Loser, and I was lucky enough to reach there just in time to witness it. I followed the villagers back to Shade and spent the next 12 days falling more and more in love with the village and its people. The Loser celebrations started in earnest that evening and continued in full swing for the next 12 days. There was a lot of singing and dancing, fueled by endless cups of chang, the local beer made out of barley. I enjoy the taste of chang, but avoid drinking it in the winter as it cools the body a lot and I invariably catch a cold. So I tried not to drink any chang for the first couple of days, but eventually relented and joined in on the fun. I even did the unthinkable and danced one evening after drinking a lot of chang. Shahdev as a village is very fascinating. The houses are old and their architecture was nothing like I've ever seen in Ladakh before. Especially fascinating are the chokangs or prayer rooms in the old houses. They have some ancient idols and even their religious texts are made of traditional parchment, which is very rare to see elsewhere in Ladakh. The people lead simple and cheerful lives. Their main job here is to take care of their animals, take them to graze, bring them back, and then process their produce like wool, butter, and cheese, which they sell to make a living. A few days after Losar, it started snowing at Shahdev. While the snow made everything beautiful and gave it a proper winter feel, it also started to worry me. It snowed continuously for 3 days without a break, and we were worried that the snow might bury the trails and make it too difficult to go back to Puktur. In the end, it snowed less than 1 feet, so going back to Puktur would not be an issue, especially since I had experienced people like Norbu to guide me. Finally, after about 12 days at Shahdev, it was time for me to leave. The entire village gathered to give me a traditional farewell called the Pumpa, where the villagers came forward one by one to serve me chang and bid me farewell. I had never experienced something like this in all my travels, and I was so overwhelmed by emotion that I actually started crying while saying my goodbyes. Actually, I left a day early before Norbu so that I can get a head start and reduce the distance that we have to walk to Puktur on the next day. So I went to the hamlet of Taltak, which is around 5 kilometers from Shahdev, and spent the night there. One of the villagers, an elderly man called Rabges, was staying there. So I spent the night at his house and left early next morning to join Norbu, who came from Shahdev. The snow hike from Taltuk to Pukhtar has to be one of the most amazing experiences of my life. It was the same trail that we walked 2 weeks back, but the fresh snow had transformed the landscape completely, making it feel like a whole different world. Although I had a 5 km head start, walking on the snow proved to be more tiring than I expected, and by 3 p.m. I was running out of energy and Pukhtar was a further 6 km ahead. So I asked Norbu to carry on and camped beside the trail. I owe a great deal of gratitude to Norbu for not only taking me to the village of his in-laws but also guiding me about the various customs and traditions followed by the people of Shadi. I woke up fresh the next morning, and with just 6 km to go, I took it real easy, taking a lot of videos and enjoying every little step on the way to Pukhtar. I finally reached the monastery at around 3 p.m, thus ending my first encounter with Shadi. The first of hopefully many more visits to the fascinating village frozen in time.